Hi, this is Gerd Leonhardt, media futurist in Basel, Switzerland, with another edition of GerdTube. Today, about the future of money. What's happening with money clearly is that because of the internet, all of a sudden we're looking at many more options of how we can pay for stuff in the future. This is crucial because money actually isn't a good instrument for lots of people to pay for virtual goods and what they do on the web. Of course, we have PayPal, we have credit cards and so on, but now we're looking at a slew of new kind of alternative currencies, including, as you can see on this slide, Facebook money. And why does Facebook money make a difference? Well, the difference is, first, I can earn Facebook money on Facebook by getting presents from others. I can earn money, and this is just now being started by Facebook. For example, if I like a brand, they could actually send me Facebook credits. If I upload lots of movies that are mine, I can earn credits. If I'm really active on Facebook, I can earn credits. And I can turn those credits around to buy real-life stuff, including movie tickets, airline tickets, downloads, and so on. So the Facebook currency essentially becomes like a virtual country. I mean, if you're looking in general, of course, Facebook is the third largest country in the world. China and India are the first two largest countries in the world, and then Facebook is the third largest country. So if Facebook has a currency called Facebook credits, right, you can expect that to be an extremely powerful tool for people to exchange services. For example, you can imagine, we used to joke about this as musicians, you know, 5 years ago or 3 years ago, can you pay your landlord, you know, for the rental with Facebook money? Well, in 2 years you can. Right? You can pay real life people, you can pay gas for your car with Facebook credits. You can convert them, you can earn them, you can buy them, you can exchange them. So this kind of currency system really creates a big difference because also it's international. It doesn't have the same sort of fee structure at PayPal. It's becoming sort of a compliant structure that we have all agreed on. Here's another page that shows you basically what's happening in terms of paying with attention. People are getting paid to tweet. For example, there's a bar in Cologne, Germany, but if you tweet about them, they give you a free beer. Right? So there is a currency there that's in development, which is attention. Right? The more I pay attention, I can get paid to do this. There are currencies like Kachingle and Flatter that if I push a button, then the blogger gets a piece of my money. And these are our business models we're going to see for producers, for musicians, for writers, and so on. To put a button, a simple button on your web page or your mobile page, and if I like what you do, then a piece of my money goes towards you. And the same goes for Farmville. I hope you don't know Farmville, because it's a very addictive Facebook game. Made $350 million last year, people buying virtual tractors to plow the virtual field on Farmville. Right? So, networked mobile social currencies are with us, and last year already $6 billion was purchased for virtual products like virtual flowers and gift cards and so on. This page shows you what's happening in mobile money. Nokia is, of course, very big in mobile money in Asia, and the combination of all these things. So we're going to see new kinds of monies coming up, both on social networks. Probably every single social network will have their own currency to be paid and to pay people. And this will be very important because I think in many ways real life money and banks have had their heyday and are beyond their peak. So these kind of ideas are very, very powerful. You should investigate it if you're into retail, how people can pay you and how you can get paid and how you can generate value. I think it's very important. The last slide shows you an example of Facebook credits, which is an easy way to buy stuff on Facebook. Translates, of course, into dollars. The same goes for Cyworld, who have their own money. There's a slide here talking about the average number of virtual transactions, which will be very interesting to see how people, this is from 2009, from Kleiner Perkins and from Mary Meeker, showing how people buy stuff in-game currency, like you can buy stuff to play a game, you can subscribe to codes, you can buy weapons for virtual games. You know, this is a huge business that's just now unfolding, especially on things like the iPad. So imagine you're sitting down to play a game on the iPad, and it's a really cool game. You bought it or you download it for free, but at a certain point it says, you know what, if you spend 5 of your Facebook credits, you can buy a faster car, or you can compete with somebody in Australia who's built their own car. You can buy it for him for $5, right? These kind of things are all going to happen. That's a huge amount of virtual transactions and currencies coming our way. Great business models for the future. And finally, I think this is also how Twitter will be paid for. There's 160 million people now using Twitter. I think there's a great commercial mechanism for microcurrencies and payments, and also, of course, for advertising. So the future of money will be fragmented in many different ways. It will not just be paid through credit cards and cash and PayPal and so, but in many different ways, the future of money is right with us. Thanks very much for listening, and come to MediaFuturist.com for more videos.